brand new clinical trial just came out looking at the effect of exercise on artery plaque. And the results are super interesting. They took patients with a lot of plaque, with angina, all on lipid-lowering treatment. So statins, antiplatelet drugs. So these are high-risk patients. And then they split them randomly. Half got the standard advice, the guidelines, eat a healthy diet, don't smoke, exercise regularly, and also managing their blood pressure and their glycated hemoglobin levels. So that was the control group that got the standard of care. The other half were the intervention group, and they started a supervised exercise program. Specifically, it was an HIIT program. HIIT stands for High Intensity Interval Training, and it's a pretty popular workout where you have bursts of high intensity activity interspersed with intervals of recovery. All of this cycled over and over. So it can be a pretty intense workout. In this study, they used mainly treadmill or stationary bike. And the workout consisted of an initial warm-up period of 10 minutes at 60 to 70% peak heart rate. Then they started the workout per se. First, a 4-minute period of high intensity, 85 to 95% peak heart rate. Then a recovery period, 3 minutes at 60 to 70% peak heart rate. And then this would just cycle over and over. The 4 minutes of high intensity and the 3 minutes of recovery, 4 times of this cycle. And finally, 5 minutes of cool down. So they did this whole workout twice a week, supervised by professional trainers. And outside of that, they were also encouraged to do more exercise at home, including more HIIT. After 6 months of this workout program, they measured the plaque in their arteries, and they compared with the values and the measurements before the trial. In the control group that was doing that standard of care, there was no significant difference in plaque dimensions, no significant increase or decrease. On the other hand, the group doing the HIIT program saw a significant reduction of plaque size. The largest lesion that the patients had, the largest segment of plaque, filled up an average of 49.5% of the artery lumen. The lumen is the hole through the tube, through the artery. And that's the value before the trial. And after 6 months of HIIT, that number came down to 48.3%. So that was a 1.2% drop. Now, is this a meaningful reduction? 1.2%? Does that make a difference? If we look at the trials with lipid-lowering treatment as a reference, so trials using statins or other cholesterol-lowering medications, because we have a lot of those, for each 1% reduction in average plaque size, we see about a 20 to 25% reduction in risk of events, like heart attacks or strokes. Now, grain of salt, this is a different intervention, different stimulus, so we don't know if the same would apply here. But just as a reference, that a 1% reduction in plaque size can reflect a very substantial reduction in risk. At the end of the day, what we really want to see is outcomes, risk of actual events like heart attacks, strokes, revascularization, death, etc. This trial doesn't report that. For that type of outcomes, you normally need longer follow-ups, more people. It's just harder to quantify than these surrogates like biomarkers or plaque size, for example. But the results of this trial are definitely really encouraging, and I'm looking forward to seeing more. The other thing that's really good to bear in mind is we talk about plaque size and a reduction in the thickness of the plaque, and that's meaningful. But what's even more critical is the composition, the structure of the plaque. The structure of a plaque can change in a way that makes it more stable and less likely to rupture without it getting any smaller. That's entirely possible. It can even get a little bit bigger while getting more stable and less of a problem overall. So just things that are good to bear in mind so we have kind of a more nuanced and more educated perspective on all of this. Another open question is how different types of exercise affect plaque and eventually outcomes. So cardio versus weights versus all kinds of sports. Here they just use this HIIT protocol, so we can't compare, so this is all TBD. Now, if this effect is real, if exercise, or at least HIIT, ends up shrinking plaque meaningfully and reproducibly, how does that work? The group doing the HIIT program also saw a statistically significant reduction of their BMI and their waist circumference. So they got a little bit leaner. Not that surprising, since they're exercising more. So one possibility is that it's the weight loss causing the reduction in plaque. Possible. On the other hand, and this is really interesting, the hemoglobin A1C, the glycated hemoglobin of the participants, as well as their LDL cholesterol and their ApoB levels were not significantly different between the controls and the group doing HIIT. And this is very relevant because, as we said, lipid-lowering treatment, lipid-lowering drugs, significantly shrink plaque. That's been shown many times. But here, in the context of this trial, we're seeing this significant reduction with constant LDL cholesterol and ApoB. Now, remember, we said in the beginning, everybody in this trial is on lipid-lowering treatment. Everybody is on a statin or a similar drug and has their LDL cholesterol and their ApoB pushed lower. Everybody in the control group and everybody in the HIIT group, because they're all high-risk patients. So their average LDL cholesterol at baseline before the trial was about 80 milligrams per deciliter, which matches the range where we see plaque stop growing in the lipid-lowering drug trials. Above that range, we see plaque growth, and the higher the LDL cholesterol, the faster the growth. Around 80, give or take, 70 to 80, is this cutoff where we see growth stop, and then under that range, with LDL cholesterol below 70 to 80, we start to see reversal, or regression as it's called. We start to see plaque get smaller. So here we're seeing a similar outcome, this regression, this reduction of plaque size, by bringing down the lipids to 80 milligrams per deciliter LDL cholesterol, this range where we normally stop growth, and then instead of bringing them down even further, we're adding this exercise program on top, and we're seeing regression with that combo, right? This is very important to understand the range where we are operating, because we might just hear a headline or just look at the title of the paper and just go, oh, exercise shrinks plaque. And we might think, oh, okay, so I'll just leave my lipids in the stratospheric range and I'll just go for a run and that should melt my plaque right off. But that is not what this study showed at all. So these observations beg all kinds of interesting questions. For example, what if we have both? What if we bring our lipids lower to the range where we normally see regression just with lipid lowering, and we add exercise on top? Maybe the plaque shrinks twice as fast. Maybe there's an additive effect, or maybe it's not additive, and the two interventions are operating through a common mechanism, and having both is not better than having either one. All questions for future research, and we'll definitely keep an eye on this type of data going forward. For more on how to lower ApoB with lifestyle, we have an entire video all about that. And here's the best workout to lower blood pressure. Check those out. I'll see you next time.